Hey everyone, Patrick LeBlanc, Principal Program Manager, Microsoft Fabric. Everyone has been asking for more low-code features in Microsoft Fabric. Well, this video demonstrates a few of the new low-code AI capabilities in Microsoft Fabric. Let's take a look.
In this demo, imagine I'm working on a data set of airline passenger feedback. My teammates put data into a lakehouse and cleaned up some of the CSVs' tables, but they left one of those CSVs to me. Let's see how native AI capabilities in Fabric can help me drill in deeper. First, I'll create a new notebook that's automatically attached to my lakehouse. From there, I can read in files and tables as Pandas or Spark data frames with just a few clicks. Let's take a closer look at those customer reviews. My data frame has information about the review author's country of origin, the date of those reviews, and more, plus the text content of the reviews themselves. People are pretty opinionated about air travel, so there's a lot to analyze here. With Fabric, we can take advantage of built-in machine learning and Gen AI capabilities to enrich this data instantly. A new AI Tools tab in my notebook ribbon lets me open up Data Wrangler, or train a new model, or get Copilot help from the chat pane. With the recently released set of AI functions in Fabric, I can also apply LLM transformations directly to my data. Here's our documentation to learn more. There are 8 AI functions, and they work on Pandas or Spark data frames, with one-line syntax so simple that you won't need docs for long. Back in our notebook, we can also generate code by selecting an input data frame and column. Here, I'm going to apply the sentiment analysis AI function to the column of airline reviews in my data frame. We'll insert that code right into our notebook and run it. You'll recall that some reviews were positive and others were less so. The LLM-generated output from my AI function reflects that range, and our interactive notebook display shows the distribution of sentiment labels if we scroll over. We'll see that there are positive values, negative values, and neutral and mixed values. Here's that distribution. Now let's do something a bit more complex. From the catalog of AI functions, I'm selecting Use a Custom Prompt. I can ask the Fabric LLM to draft responses to the author of each review and personalize them based on the text content. For bonus points, I'm specifying that the responses should be drafted in the native language of the author's country of origin. I'll copy that dynamically updated code into a new cell in my notebook. Then I'll hit Run, and the AI function will attempt to generate responses based on my custom prompt and on each row of input data. Now, our original data frame had a column containing the country of origin for each passenger. That should be what determines the language of the AI function's response if everything goes right. Let's give it a moment and then take a look. Some of our passengers were from Germany, others were from France, and others were from Turkey. If we scroll over to our custom responses, sure enough, we'll see responses in German, French, and Turkish. I could keep going with other AI functions, but for now, let's get this enriched data back to my team. I need Copilot's help writing my data frame to my lakehouse. In addition to the chat interface, I can now access Copilot directly from any code cell for a more seamless developer experience. Here, I'm asking for code that converts my Pandas data frame into a Spark data frame and then saves it as a new table called Airline. We'll hit Send and give Copilot a moment to process. The output will be custom code. And once it comes back and I accept it, I could even get Copilot to explain, optimize, or document that code with a new set of quick actions. For now, I'm going to delete this import statement, plus some commented lines, and then save that enriched data to my lakehouse. Back in my lakehouse, I'll refresh my tables, and there's my enriched airline feedback. It's ready for my team to act on, enrich further, or visualize. With Fabric, Gen AI fits in seamlessly.
Wow, what a great video. If you have any questions, comments about this video, or you'd like to see other videos about Microsoft Fabric, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If this is your first time visiting the Microsoft Fabric YouTube channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button. If you like this video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Microsoft and this guy, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.